Good afternoon and welcome to this final recital of the 2019 to 2020 academic year. It has certainly been an interesting year. However, it has been wonderful that we've still been able to provide you with wonderful music via mediums such as Facebook and YouTube during this time. We're very grateful to all of your support and to all of you who have supported the recitals over the past 4 or 5 months. In this final recital, I will play various works on the organ, all of them from the French organ school, and three of them from the more romantic period of the French school. I always think that structuring an organ recital is a challenge in itself, but I have tried to structure it in the form of a standard symphonic work, and so there are four contrasting movements in this recital, all taken from different works, but hopefully to give a great balance of styles and tempo and colour. We start with the first movement from Vidor's Sixth Symphony. This was a work that was first premiered at the Paris World Exhibition in 1878. There are two strong themes. There is a stated chorale melody, contrasted by a recitative section, and these two themes are developed in the standard sonata form that you would expect in the first movement of a symphony. For the second part of the recital, there is a short piece by Clérambault, who is a French Baroque composer and was organist at Saint-Sulpice, similar to Vidor himself. The piece is the Plangeot from his douzième, his second set of works for organ. The plangeur refers to the sound of the organ and refers to the stops that are being used. So you have the principal chorus with the mixtures, the fourniture, and the cimbale. And so when you listen to the piece, you'll notice the colour throughout contains many, many high sounds as well as low sounds in the registration. The third piece, which will be the slow movement of our symphony, is the Adagio from Vienne's Third Symphony, which was completed in 1912 and written for the organ of Notre Dame in Paris. There is a lot of influence from César Franck, and this movement Vienne was particularly proud of, and he orchestrated it in the 1920s to be played by an orchestra in New York. I particularly chose this piece because as you get to the central section where it's harmonically most developed, in the pedals you can hear the theme of We'll Meet Again. Now, of course, We'll Meet Again was not written for another 30 years after this piece. However, it seemed somewhat appropriate to have this particular tune after its associations with lockdown and, of course, the death of Vera Lynn but a few weeks ago. And the final piece in the recital will be the joyous flourish of Longley's treatment of the 13th century Te Deum melody. Again, contrasting sections, you have the abrupt accented sections at the beginning and the end, contrasted by the flowing section of the centre. And so I hope that you will enjoy this recital and find it to be well balanced and contrasting for all of your musical needs. During lockdown, FOSAM have continued providing musical education for the choristers here at St Alphege via singing lessons and instrumental lessons online. Of course, all of these things cost a lot of money to set up, and during lockdown we have been unable to raise money as we would normally do so. And so if you enjoy this recital and in response you would like to donate something towards the workings of the Friends of St Alphege Music, then please click on the link below in the description, or you can contact me directly on 07935 962 677. But again, thank you for all of your support of these recital series, and we hope, everyone at St Alphege, that we will see you in September and that our recital series may go back to what it was, where we can all join together in the wonderful building of St Alphege. Thank you.